Well, good morning. We are tracking breaking news this morning. Washington Governor Jay Inslee has ordered the activation of the National Guard following chaos in Spokane. You can take a look at this live out here this morning in downtown Spokane. Thousands of people came together to protest peacefully, but hours later, after the protests died down, the scene turned a little bit different in the downtown corridor. Well, thanks so much for waking up with us here on Up with KREM. I'm Jen York. Again, we are tracking breaking news this morning. A quieter scene here in downtown Spokane following a night of unrest. As you can see behind me, the National Guard is out and about this morning here in Spokane. We've seen a number of different troops patrolling the Riverfront Park as well as the downtown corridor, making sure everything is safe this morning. When many of you went to bed last night, it was a bit unruly in downtown Spokane. With demonstrators that were left over from a peaceful protest yesterday. It was the second group of demonstrators that turned violent overnight. And again, as you can see live here this morning, we do have the National Guard here in Spokane. Quite a scene for Spokane, not something that we're typically used to seeing. Seeing the National Guard being deployed here because of a protest. Typically, Spokane protests remain quite peaceful. And yesterday's protest did remain peaceful. It was authorities that say it was a second group of people that turned the situation yesterday violent. You can see the National Guard pausing there in front of Wheatland Bank. They've got a number of different windows boarded up overnight, as this area was very active last night. This stretch of road along Spokane Falls Boulevard was very, very busy. We have a number of different debris canisters still left in the road as authorities work to push some of the protesters back overnight. And that's just the scene where I'm at here in Riverfront Park. We do have team coverage this morning tracking the damage in downtown as well as what you're seeing on social media. Nicole Hernandez is giving us a look at the downtown damage. She's been running around trying to look at what's being done this morning as the cleanup now gets underway. And Dana Marie McNichol is in studio sharing what you all shared on social media from the protests. We'll check in with both of them here in just a few minutes. So first, let's walk back and tell you exactly what happened yesterday to give you a better perspective of the situation. First, this is what it looked like yesterday. It's estimated about 3,000 people joined the protest. The massive crowd yesterday again protested peacefully all afternoon and into the early evening. It was just before 7 p.m. that things turned violent. According to city leaders, a second group of people became aggressive. Spokane police fired tear gas at demonstrators, while some people reportedly looted stores and smashed business windows. A Spokane County Sheriff says he had great conversations with the protesters before all of this started. And he says the people behind the damage disrespected our Black community.
You make change by getting to know each other, and we make change by making sure that everybody knows. You know, Minneapolis, I have one word for it: inexcusable. That's it. And that's how the majority of law enforcement in America look at that. And we only fix this if we join together, and we only fix this if we get to know each other, and we only fix this if we respect each other. My intent is I will work just as I have for the last 14 years with my community. I don't care of what color, to solve any problem they have.
I think Spokane set a very powerful example today of how a community peacefully and respectfully comes together to support each other and the nation when we are hurting, when we are going through events and situations like this.
Now, you just heard there from Spokane Mayor Nadine Woodward as well. We will be talking to her live at 6:45 this morning following the city's curfew overnight and what is expected today and what people here in Spokane can expect following this protest. Again, I'm live here in Riverfront Park this morning surveying the damage overnight from the unruly protests in Spokane. Nicole Hernandez is also in downtown Spokane giving us a better look at the damage and the cleanup now underway. Good morning.
Hey, good morning, Jen. So I am outside of the Nike store right now along Main Avenue, and you can see the windows here are completely boarded up, and we have a giant pile of glass right outside the front doors of Nike here. There's also some damage along the frames of the doors here. Not sure exactly what happened there, but obviously this was a result of the violence that started with the protests yesterday evening. So we actually just found out in the past few minutes that because of all of these protests and such, that the Spokane Transit Authority will not be starting up their service again until 7 this morning. They were going to start at 6:30 this morning. They've pushed that back a half hour and will now be starting at 7. So these protests did start out peaceful around 2 p.m. yesterday. It wasn't until later in the evening, about 6:30, that things started getting violent. The city of Spokane did say that they think that it is a separate group that started this violence here in downtown Spokane. Just before 7 p.m., the Spokane police put out tear gas into a group of demonstrators at Riverfront Park. The tear gas started while some people reportedly looted stores and smashed business windows. Now, it's still unclear whether anyone was warned in advance that the tear gas was going to be deployed. Here you can see a woman being helped by other demonstrators after she got tear gas in her eyes. Now, take a listen to what Spokane Sheriff Ozzy Knezovich said about the situation.
So, I know that SPD is doing the best they can to protect this community. The Sheriff's Office is working arm in arm with them, along with Kootenai County Sheriff's Office and many agencies throughout this region. So we have a lot of help, and it is our intent to protect our community as well as we can.
All right, so you can see there's a mask here in the pile of glass outside of Nike. This is the biggest physical damage that we've seen so far. Not sure if other stuff has been cleaned up already. There have been people out and about cleaning up some debris that has been all over the roads. Particularly Howard and Main had a lot of debris. Along Howard and Riverside, there was a lot of graffiti, spray paint of expletives along the roads on businesses. And several businesses are now down near Nordstrom getting boarded up as well, because we're not sure whether or not this will continue, but protesters did say this was going to be lasting 24 hours. Live in Spokane, I'm Nicole Hernandez.
Nicole, thank you so much for that live report. Now, due to the protests, there are a number of delays and closures happening today in downtown Spokane. Spokane Transit will delay the start of all of its services. All routes are canceled until approximately 6:30, so you have about 20 minutes or so until buses will be back up and running. For a service update, though, you are asked to visit SpokaneTransit.com. Also, the Spokane County Courthouse will be closed today. So we also want to talk about what led up to last night's chaos here in downtown Spokane. Yesterday afternoon, protesters gathered at the Red Wagon in Riverfront Park. Around 3 p.m., about 3,000 participants marched peacefully from the park to the courthouse. The protesters chanted, they held up signs, and again interacted peacefully with law enforcement. Some SPD officers even took a knee with protesters, and that gave them a round of applause. The protests then moved downtown. This went on for several hours. After 5 p.m., some businesses downtown closed, including the Apple Store, which put up a few wooden barricades. But it was not until about 6:45 last night when city leaders say a second group smashed windows to businesses in the downtown core and began looting. Officers deployed tear gas and other non-lethal weapons into the crowd. And after 8 p.m., Spokane police issued a public safety alert for people near downtown, asking people to avoid the area. Later in the evening, city leaders put a curfew in place and requested the help of the National Guard. And just before 11 last night, Governor Jay Inslee issued a statewide activation of the National Guard. And he did that. He activated the state's National Guard due in part to Spokane County's request. Spokane County Sheriff Ozzy Knezovich requested the National Guard to help keep the community safe from the separate group who turned the protests violent.
I have requested the National Guard. That request is being processed right now, and it is on the very, very fast track.
Well, last night, the Washington National Guard tweeted it will deploy soldiers as a proactive measure. Leaders say they will only mobilize when requested and work under the direction of a requesting agency. Now, yesterday, Governor Inslee also gave some insight on state protocol to hold officers accountable and how procedures will be moving forward.
We also have improved our ability to train officers in de-escalation tactics to reduce the confrontations that occur. And we are not done in that regard. There is more work to be done.
Now, the governor adds he is proud of the existing laws already in Washington in place to hold police officers accountable for violence that occurs on the job. Now, this morning, coming up later in the program, we will be speaking with the local chapter president of the Spokane NAACP. President Curtis Robinson will be joining us in our 8 o'clock hour coming up on the CW22. For now, we also want to check in with Dana Marie McNichol back in the studio with more on what she's seeing on social media.
Good morning, Jen. Well, that's right. As protests continue across the country, social media has been the platform for demonstrations to share their firsthand accounts and messages and frustrations over racial injustice. Now, many are pushing against just beyond that trending hashtag. They want to see action. Now, with yesterday's protests in downtown Spokane, many people use Snapchat to share videos. As you see there, firsthand accounts. Snap Maps is a way to look at videos directly where and how they were taken. Now, in these videos, you can see clouds of tear gas, demonstrators running police activity, and people raising their arms in protest. Again, this is a live view from Spokane downtown last night.
Hands up! Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
We can hear the variety of chants there protesters use to communicate their frustration to police. Now, this video was shot inside a person's car. They caught the demonstration going on downtown with a large crowd and heavy police presence. This did follow the peaceful protest at the Red Wagon and the Spokane Courthouse. In addition to Snapchat, Instagram stories and Twitter are other popular social media platforms used to show protest videos and spread awareness, trending on all platforms really over the weekend. Now, across the state, protests in the Seattle area started peacefully. However, Saturday night, some grew into violence in downtown Seattle. City leaders issued a mandatory curfew last night. It expired at 5 a.m. this morning. Surrounding cities are under a curfew until 7 a.m. Several police cars were set on fire. Dozens of businesses were looted and at least 55 people were arrested. Some protesters say the original reason for the protest got lost in violence.
I'm mad because we're supposed to be fighting for the injustice of George. We're not using this as an excuse to be thugs like they call us. We aren't thugs, we're people, and we're hurt and we're mad.
Governor Jay Inslee ordered the Washington National Guard to help the city of Seattle. Guard personnel are unarmed and work under the direction of Seattle city leadership. Protesters have also been outside the White House in Washington, D.C. for days. White House leaders told CBS News the Secret Service moved President Trump to the underground bunker used in the past during terrorist attacks. They say it's an abundance of caution. President Trump has urged governors to call up the National Guard if needed to help with protests. Now, since George Floyd's death, protesters have stretched to every corner of the country.
No justice!
Many are peaceful and focused on wanting to hold police accountable.
We are out here, we're peaceful. We are different from whoever's rioting.
Protests have been going on for the past 6 days. The Associated Press reports over 4,000 people have been arrested. Now, we will be bringing you the latest coverage all morning long. For the latest information, text the word protest to 509-448-2000 and we'll have all that information sent straight to your phone. It is 6:11 now. I'll send it over to you, Evan, for your forecast.
Good morning, Dana Marie. Yeah, we are tracking mainly dry weather this week. Of course, quite a contrast from what we saw Saturday night, especially where we ran into some thunderstorms, lightning, rain showers, wind, all of the above, really. Now, as we start off your day, we are picking up on just a bit of cloud cover. You can see what we're mainly tracking, though, is a little bit of wet weather down toward the south of us. So around the northern Oregon border, pushing into the Palouse, we're starting to see some some of those light drizzle showers make their way in. It's not going to be especially intense going through the next several hours and the next couple days. We're actually going to encounter more dry weather than anything else. This wet weather that we're seeing is kind of just a product of what's going on around Oregon and Northern California, where that shower system is just pushing farther to the north. So we're not going to be picking up on all that much dry weather going into the next couple days, but the areas that could see wet weather for this afternoon are going to be through the central and southern panhandle. Most of Washington expected to stay dry. We could see an influx of clouds, though. Temperature is going to warm up to the upper 60s this afternoon. If we hit 70, that will be a little bit warmer than where we are actually anticipating temperatures to rest. We will probably end up sticking to mostly the upper 60s. 68 degrees is about that forecast high, even with the sun coming out toward your evening hours. Tuesday and Wednesday going to be a little bit warmer, low 70s in the forecast, mostly dry conditions with sunny skies expected. It's not until we hit about Friday that we do see some additional showers join us for the weekend. It'll be about Friday night and Saturday where we do see that wet weather before things dry out once again on Sunday. But enjoy the dry week while you can. Temperatures running just about normal with low 70s in the afternoon hours. It is 6:14 right now. I'll send things back out to Jen York, who is live in downtown Spokane.
Evan, thank you for that quick look at weather. This morning, still ahead on Up With KREM, we will have live coverage all morning long following the unrest here overnight in Spokane. This morning, we will hear from Spokane Mayor Nadine Woodward and give you a first look at downtown since protesters cleared out late last night. You're watching Up With KREM.